Suppose you are riding east on a New Jersey road, 50 miles out of New York. You meet a man walking west. He is gaunt, begrimed, unshaven, unwashed. He hobbles on a twisted cane. His clothes are torn. He looks the picture of hunger, friendlessness, and woe. You are moved with pity. You stop and ask him, "Why so forlorn?" He answers, "I have no friends, no money, and no food." You ask him, "Where are you going?" He answers, "I don't know." You ask him, "Why did you leave the city?" He answers, "I forget the reason just now." You ask him, "How long are you going on like this?" He answers, "Till I drop from weariness or fall ill. Then someone may give me a lift." On the road of destiny, the average man is walking west. In the mental geography on the map of his mind, he is aimless and powerless, as a ragged, starving tramp. He hobbles on a twisted cane of tradition, habit, or misinformation. He hasn't enough mental food to keep him nourished, and most of what he has wouldn't pass a pure food inspector. He follows a rut of routine, looking neither ahead nor above. His psychic raiment is mud and tatters. His moral expression is meaningless, like that of a man with a wandering mind. He does not know where he is going or why he is going anywhere. He is waiting for someone to give him a lift or send him to a hospital. Why all this vacuity, poverty, tragedy in the life journey of the average man? Loss of the power, loss of the path of concentration.